Very good morning to you all, my dear students. I welcome to today's class. We will start chapter 4 today. Chapter 4, the name of the chapter is expansions. Expansion means, look, you have studied the expansions for a plus b the whole square, a minus b the whole square. A plus b the whole square, how do you expand a square? Plus 2ab plus b square. No, this is already studied, right? I don't need to explain. A square plus 2ab plus b square. That means a square plus 2ab plus b square is the expansion of a plus b the whole square. Okay? Now, similarly, a minus b the whole square. How is it? A square minus 2ab plus b square. Clear? We will see another expansion now, third one. This is not studied yet. A plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square. If you add this first two, what would be the result? Let us see that. Okay, a plus b the whole square plus, till here it is a plus b the whole square. A minus b the whole square. Second part is a minus b the whole square. So, this is the expansion. Instead of a plus b the whole square, I'm going to substitute the whole thing. A square plus 2ab plus b square. A square plus 2ab plus b square. This is written in place of a plus b the whole square. Correct? Now, a minus b the whole square is place what we can write? A minus b whole square is equal to this thing. So, plus, this plus is here. A square minus 2ab plus b square. Clear now? Is it clear? A square minus 2ab. So, in fact, since it is a plus here, even if you put bracket, doesn't matter. This is a plus b the whole square. And this is a minus b the whole square. Now, see, I'm removing this bracket. One step I am saving. If I remove the bracket, how it will look like? A square plus a square. 2a square, correct? Plus 2ab minus 2ab, this becomes 0. Plus b square plus another b square. 2b square. Now, you get a 2a square plus 2b square. That is, 2 is common here. 2 here, 2 here. What can we take? A square here plus b square. Now, 2a square plus 2b square. Alright. So, the expansion, this is the third expansion, that is a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square is equal to 2 into a square plus b square. Now, a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square, the expansion of 2 into a square plus b square. Okay. New one. This is a new expansion. Now, similarly, we have the fourth one, a plus b the whole square minus a minus b whole square. But a plus and the minus, okay? Let us see that. A plus b the whole square. A plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now comes minus. Minus. This minus is here, okay? A minus b the whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. So, yeah. Now, when minus comes outside, out of the second bracket, of any bracket, what would happen? The terms inside will change their signs. Here, there won't be any change. A square plus 2ab plus b square. So here, just to say, we can put one more step here, okay? Just in order to save one step, I removed the bracket there itself. Minus, see? My a square plus, inside the bracket it is plus a square. When the bracket is removed, plus a square will become minus a square. Now, then minus 2ab will become plus 2ab. Now, it is minus here. When bracket is opened, it becomes plus 2ab. Then minus of plus, this becomes minus. Opposite sign we have to give. Okay. A square is inside this plus, minus. While opening, it will become plus. Minus becomes plus becomes minus. Here there is no change. Okay. A square minus A square, 0. Now, then plus B square minus B square, 0. Plus 2AB plus 2AB. 2AB plus 2AB, 4AB. Now, that is, when A plus B the whole square minus A minus B the whole square, when you take the difference between these two, you get 4ab. That is the second. That is also a new expansion. a plus b the whole square plus a minus b whole square 2 into a square plus b square, a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square, it is 4ab. Alright, now we have an example question. Okay, alright, let us discuss an example now. A plus b the whole square plus a minus b whole square, the expansion is here, and the expansion of a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square is here. These two, we are going to apply maybe this formula now. Alright, if a plus b is equal to 9 and a b is equal to negative 22, find a minus b. We don't have the values of a b separately. We have a plus b together. Maybe a b is not our requirement. It is not our concern. A plus b is equal to 9. A b is equal to 80-22. When a into a and b are multiplied, you are getting 80-22. When a and b are added, we are getting 9. If it is so, find a minus b. We are not asked to find a and b separately. A minus b together only we require. Isn't it? Apo, look, a plus b. AB, A plus B, AB, A minus B, A minus B. So A plus B is here. This, instead of A plus B, we have a value to substitute. Correct? Instead of A plus B, we have a value to substitute 9. Instead of AB, we have a value negative 22. AB is the sign of the A and B separately we are not substituting. Wherever you have A into B, there you can substitute negative 22. Find A minus B. This term is missing, a minus b the whole square. If once you are getting a minus b the whole square, suppose a minus b the whole square we are getting as, a minus b the whole square we get as 25. No, if a minus b the whole square is 25, a minus b name become, take the square root, isn't it? Take the square root of 25, root of 25, it is equal to 5, plus 5 or minus 5, we will do that. Okay, so now, for the, yeah, plus, one more thing I will tell you. Plus root of 25 is the root of 25 is the, it is plus 5 or negative 5. In the option, it can be either plus 5 or minus 5. What is the reason? If we get 25, 25 is equal to 5 into 5. 5 into 5 is 25, plus 5 into plus 5 is 25. Minus 5 into minus 5 also is 25. Adhukondana, plus 5 into plus 5 is 25. Adhukonda, this implies root of 25 is equal to plus 5. Negative 5 into negative 5 is also equal to positive 25. Negative into negative also is positive, right? Right? Adhukonda, square root of 25, it can also be equal to minus 5. Yenna othrikeyum vandhamna angane padikkunda. There are two square roots for a perfect square. One is positive, another one is negative. See, positive square root is the principal square root. Principal square root. Negative also is a square root. So, now onwards, you must remember this also. Plus 4 is equal to, root of 4 is equal to, it can be plus 2 or minus 2. Together, how do you write, you know, plus, minus. First plus, then below plus, you put a minus sign. And we read it as plus or minus 2. Root of 4 is plus or minus 2. Root of 9 is plus or minus 3. Okay, for 3 here. Right. Look at this now. We are going to solve this. Look at this. We have a two formula. We studied two formula. One is a plus b whole square, a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square. A plus b, yes, here we have a plus b. A minus b, yes, here we have a minus b. And here, the value of a square plus b square. In this question, a square plus b square and the sign number would gone. A square plus b square either given or not given doesn't matter, but it must be present. It is not present here. Only a plus b is in here. A plus b is there, a minus b also there. And third value given is of a b. Here no mention of a b. Here there is no mention of a into b. A into b is seen here. That is why we are applying the second formula, second expansion. Okay, what is here? That is why we apply the second expansion. But in the second expansion, we have a plus b, we have a minus b, we have a b. A plus b, a minus b, a b. Whichever is not given, that we can find out. Okay. Among these three, 1, 2, 3, one will be missing. Sometimes a minus b is missing. Here a minus b is missing. Maybe a b can be missed also. A plus b also may be missed. Alright. അപ്പോ വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് സോ വിച്ച് ഫോർമുല ആർ വി ഗോയിങ് ടു യൂസ് സെക്കൻഡ് ഫോർമുല അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സെക്കൻഡ് എക്സ്പാൻഷൻ വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു യൂസ് ഓക്കെ സോ ലിസൺ വി ഹാവ് എ പ്ലസ് ബി സൊല്യൂഷൻ എ പ്ലസ് ബി ദ ഹോൾ സ്ക്വയർ മൈനസ് എ മൈനസ് ബി ദ ഹോൾ സ്ക്വയർ ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു ഫോർ എ ബി ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് എന്താണ് വേണ്ടത് എ മൈനസ് ബി ഹോൾ സ്ക്വയർ ഓക്കെ വി വിൽ ഡു ലൈക് ദിസ് A plus B, let us substitute. Okay, before that, what you can do is A minus B whole square, and we want the value of A minus B the whole square. A minus B the whole square is negative here. A minus B the whole square is minus I. If there are three terms, 1, 2, 3. This second term we will take to the right side. Because we have to isolate it. A minus B is the value alone we need, right? So a minus b actually a minus b is not alone, it has a square also. The whole thing we will shift to the right side, okay? So that means minus of a minus b the whole square will become a minus b the whole square. Plus minus becomes plus. If minus I don't have a plus I mark, okay? And then a plus b the whole square 4ab I am taking to the left side. Right now it is in the right at the right side. Plus 4ab will become minus 4ab. Da. Sign change. Sign is changed. A plus b whole square remains near itself. A minus b whole square is minus of a minus b whole square is taken to the right side. Okay. So, what do you get? Now he substitutes. Okay, now we will substitute. A plus b the whole square. A plus b the square. A plus b is 9. 9 square. Da. A plus b the square will give 9. And minus in the 4ab, 4 we can't change. AB's place we can give negative 22. No, AB into 22. 4 minus 22 is 4 minus 22. No, 4ab is the same. AB, 4 into A into B. Sorry, 4 into AB. Into AB's value is negative 22. No, now is equal to A minus B the whole square. This is what we are going to find. A minus B whole square. Keep the same. 9 square is now calculation is simplification 81 minus minus plus 80 yes 88 plus 88 becomes is equal to a minus b the whole square. Right? This will become 169 when you add it is equal to a minus b the whole square. A minus b the whole square is 169. A minus b the whole square is equal to 169. Therefore, a minus b square root. Le, square root of 169. That is 13 into 13 is 169. 13 into 13 is 169. So, what is the answer? It is plus or minus 13. Plus or minus 13 is the value of a minus b. Is it clear to you? Plus or minus 13. Okay. Other or the yeah. Now let us discuss a question from the exercise. Alright. Question number 6 from page number 58. Okay. If a minus b is equal to 7 and a b is equal to 18, find a plus b. In the previous question, we were asked to find A minus B. A minus B can be given number of parameter. Here A minus B is given. A B also is given. A plus B is required. Right. Upon, let us see. A minus B. Where do you find A minus B? Here A minus B is there. A B is not there. A plus B of course here. Right. A minus B and A plus B are here. But A B, this given A B is not mentioned here. Not reflected in the first expansion. All the three can be seen in the second expansion only like in the previous example. A minus B, A, B, A plus B. A minus B is here, A, B is here, A plus B is here. So, we will take second expansion here also. Okay. That is, the difference from the example that we did was, here A minus B, in the previous question, A minus B was required. Here A plus B is required. Okay, same formula, we have a plus b the whole square minus a minus b the whole square is equal to 4ab. Yes, in that we need a plus b. So let us keep a plus b the whole square alone. A plus b the whole square. This is what we require. No, that particular term we have to keep alone. Is equal to 4ab minus of a minus b will become plus of a minus b. Plus a minus b. Don't open the bracket. Okay. If you open the bracket, we cannot substitute. A minus b is seven. We can substitute only in the place of a minus b. So no opening of bracket. Here, what will happen? This minus will become plus in the other side. Alright. That is equal to a plus b the whole square out of the day. A plus b square a plus b. 4 into a into b. 4 into a into b. A b is 18. A b is value is 18. Plus a minus b is 7. Square 1 7 square. Okay. Apo you get 72 plus 49. That is equal to. You are getting 121. A plus b the whole square is 121. Therefore, a plus b square root of 121 plus or minus 11. You are getting plus or minus 11. Okay. And I hope you understood all. Just these two formulas only you have to memorize. Memorize these two expansions. Okay. And then problems can be solved. Question number, page number, same page, 58. 6 and question 5 you will do as homework. Okay, and that is all for today. Hope you have understood it. Okay, have a good day. Thank you.